Hello, Paso. Welcome to Fact Friday. I'm Martin Padilla. On this edition of Fact Friday, I'm going to be talking to you about cross-contamination. Now, what is cross-contamination? Cross-contamination is a process by which bacteria or other microorganisms are unintentionally transferred from one substance or object to another with harmful effect. Now, for this Fact Friday, I'm going to be doing a demonstration on how cross-contamination can still happen even while wearing gloves. Now, wearing gloves isn't necessarily a bad thing, but we want to warn people that it can still happen even if you're wearing gloves and how you can prevent the spread of germs. Now, for this demonstration, I'm going to be wearing gloves and I'm going to be using paint as a substitution for germs. And this wallet made out of cardboard and this phone made out of cardboard for the sake of not dirtying my things. Now, let's say you go to the grocery store and the first thing you do is you grab a cart and you use a disinfecting wipe to disinfect the cart. Now, you're off to a good start. You have your gloves, you're disinfecting the cart, and you're going around looking for your items and you grab one of those items. So now, you have germs on your hands from grabbing that item. Let's say you use both hands. So now you have germs on your gloves. And let's say you're going around and you get a text. And you know, people can't stay off their phone, so they grab their phone and you're texting. And now you have those germs on your phone. Let's say you put your phone away and you keep on going around the store looking for those items and you get a phone call. So now you keep grabbing, now you have more germs from all the other items that you've been grabbing, and you grab your phone, it's ringing, you put it on your face, so now you have those germs on your face, on your gloves. Let's say you put your phone back down once again. So now you're going around the store shopping for more items, and let's say you get an itch on your face. So now you get an itch, and now you're scratching your nose. You think nothing's wrong because you're wearing gloves, but now these germs are on your face. Let's say you grab all the items that you need and now you're at the checkout. So once you're at the checkout, you grab your wallet, you have even more germs. Let's say you were grabbing more stuff, you grab your wallet, you're opening it up to grab the cash, credit card, or debit card. So now your wallet has all these germs as well. So let's say you're finished paying, you put your wallet back in your pocket, you put your phone in your pocket, you're walking to your car. Now you grab the door handle from your car, and so now you're getting these germs from the door handle and it's spreading from your gloves to the door handle. You're grabbing your keys, or let's just say you took off your gloves already. But now you have all these germs on your wallet and on your phone and on your face. Now it's recommended that you don't touch anything with these gloves. Once you get home, you take out your wallet, you take out your keys, you take out your phone. You're not wearing gloves anymore because you dispose of them. So now you're grabbing these items that clearly have all these germs still, and now you're touching them without gloves. So now these germs are now on your hands instead of the gloves. So we recommend that you disinfect your items as well. You wash your hands to dispose of any germs that are on there. You wash your face so you won't have any germs on your face. Wearing gloves isn't necessarily a bad thing if you don't touch anything at all. So once you dispose of those gloves, please wash your hands for at least 20 seconds to prevent any other germs from spreading. Now, there are a lot of residents who wear gloves to the store, and while this is recommended, it is also recommended that you dispose of them properly. You have to throw them in the trash. You can't be throwing them in the grocery cart or on the floor. You have to be practicing safety etiquette and be considerate of these businesses and how to dispose of these items properly. Now, you can find all this information on our social media and by visiting epstrong.org. We'll see you guys on the next Fact Friday.